There's Scott making a mess. He's smoothing off the section where he had to cut the wall to rebalance the tub in there. And he made excuse Greg's laundry. Greg hadn't done his laundry yet. But yeah, he made this mess here already, sanding down where the stairs used to go up in the attic. He fixed that along there. So this ceiling's just about ready to paint here in the hallway. And then we had to, there was a hole he had to cut there to reattach the bathroom sink. The bathroom sink had legs on it at one time, but we took the legs off and quickly found out that the sink wasn't really attached to much in the wall. So Scott cut a hole and firmed up its anchorage inside the wall. So that's why that hole was there. But, yep, he's made a mess. I'm not sure if I've got another vacuum cleaner bag to handle all this dust or not, but we'll find out soon. I might go ahead and start sucking some of this up. And Greg got a new car yesterday, and it's out in the driveway. We'll walk out there in a little while and show you that. And for right now, I'm going to get the vacuum out and clean this up a little bit. Say hi, Piper. Piper, tell them what you're doing this weekend. Say, I'm in charge, and these people are wrecking my house. And I'm very ill She is ill-tempered, and she's just, she doesn't behave very well. Do you, Piper? They don't want to see your fanny. Hey. Hey. Look at her little socks. She's got on orange pantaloons. Hey. Don't knock the tissues down. See, she thinks she's in charge. And she's not real happy with Scott. Scott's not real happy with the wall. He's in the hall adding more to it, the ceiling. So, but you can see we've made some progress in the last couple times we've been down here. I'm not feeling good today, so I'm not being very much help, but we got down here yesterday and I did all of our laundry from the cottage, plus I mowed the lawn, so I feel like I've done at least something down here. Oh, and I cleaned the kitchen up, so it was all nice and clean. And used some stuff on the stainless to make it shiny again. And it smells good in here. So we're making progress. We'll get there eventually. Okay, I told y'all I would show you. This is Greg's new car. I'll come over here in the shade. So now he's got this car, he's got that car, and he has our old truck. So a lot for him to keep up with. I keep hoping he'll sell the old car, but he says he was gonna restore it one day. But this is his new car. And he's real tickled with it. So now I'm off to get Scott and I a sub sandwich. So talk to you later. Scott had me stop and take a video of Obama gas for y'all.
That's right. It's the Obama station.
It's Obama's gas. See? They've even got his picture up there. It's only $1.83 a gallon. Woohoo! And now we're back at the cottage. I just thought I'd show Mary I hung the wind chime here on the porch. And I've been out here calling Tippy and Callie. They weren't here when we got back. And I'm hoping they'll return soon. I should have took Tippy with me. Hopefully he'll show back up. But Howie was here. He was hungry. So, whew, sorry. Didn't mean to shake y'all, but a doggone butterfly came up out of nowhere and scared me. The zinnias are looking kind of haggardy. I need to get out here and do some cleanup. That red one's real pretty back there with the yellow center. That's real pretty. And there's an orange one. I love zinnias. Oh, there goes that little butterfly. And that's what flew up and scared me a second ago. Pretty. So this is just wrapping it up, and we'll start a new week. Hope you all had a great weekend. Bye now.